In this video, I will discuss some Newton laws of motion problems from previous year's question paper of GE Main. This is the first question. A rocket which has a mass of 3.5 × 10⁴ kg is blasted upwards with an initial acceleration of 10 m/s². Then the initial thrust of the blast is. So this is the rocket. The forces acting on the rocket are its weight mg, the upward thrust, and as a result of it, it's accelerating upwards with an acceleration a. So writing the equation, we get f minus mg equal to m into a. So from that, the upward thrust f is m into a plus g, and the acceleration is 10 m/s². So from this, we get the upward thrust as 7 × 10⁵ N. So the correct option is option 2. This is the next question. Three forces start acting simultaneously on a particle moving with velocity v. These forces are represented in magnitude and direction by three sides of a triangle ABC. The particle will now move with velocity. So you have to find the net force acting on the particle. Since the three forces form a closed figure or a closed polygon, F1 plus F2 plus F3 equal to 0, the net force acting on it equal to m into a, this is by Newton's second law of motion, and f net is 0 because it forms a closed polygon. So from this, you get the acceleration acting on the particle is 0. And acceleration rate of change of velocity, and since rate of change of velocity is 0, it means that the velocity is constant. So the correct option is option D. Option 4. This is the next question. A block of mass m is pulled along a horizontal frictionless surface by a rope of mass m. If a force P is applied at the free end of the rope, the force exerted by the rope on the block is. So this is the system. The mass m is being pulled by a rope of mass m. So the rope is not massless, it has got a mass m, and the force that's being applied at the free end of the rope is P. So if you draw the free body diagram individually of the mass m and the rope, let the tension which is the rope pulls this mass m be T. So from this we get T equal to m into A, and from the free body diagram of the rope which has got a mass m, we get P minus T as m into A. So from this we get P minus T as, and the acceleration we can get from here as tension by m. So from this we get the tension as capital M divided by small m plus m into P. So the correct option is option 4. So in the case where the rope is massless, we will expect the tension to remain constant throughout. So let us see whether the derived result matches with that. So when you put m equal to 0 in this one, we get tension as same as P. So this way we can check whether the obtained answer is correct or not. This is the next question. A horizontal force of 10 Newton is necessary to just hold a block stationary against a wall. The coefficient of friction between the block and the wall is 0.2. The weight of the block is. So a 10 Newton force is applied, and this is the minimum force that is required to keep this block stationary. So this is a free body diagram. The weight mg acting downwards, the friction force acting upwards, and here is the minimum force that is required to hold this block. Since this force is the minimum force required to hold this block, this friction force will be maximum. So mg equal to F, and friction force is maximum, so it's mu into n. So from this we get the weight of the block as 2 Newton. The correct option is option 4. This is the next question. A marble block of mass 2 kg lying on ice, when given a velocity of 6 m/s, is stopped by friction in 10 seconds. Then the coefficient of friction is. So this is a marble block of weight mass 2 kg. It has got a velocity of 6 m/s, and it stops after some time, and the velocity becomes 0, and the time it takes to stop is 10 seconds. So from this we have to find the acceleration. So we can use this equation of motion v equal to u plus at. Final velocity is 0, initial velocity is 6, and the time taken for the velocity to drop from 6 to 0 is 10 seconds. So from this you get the acceleration is minus 6/10. From the free body diagram of this marble, we get friction force equal to minus m into a, and friction force is mu into mg because it's moving, From this we get mu as minus A by G, and A is negative quantity minus 6 by 10. So from this we get the coefficient of friction mu as 0.06. The correct option is option 3.